Aptera has made significant progress in 2022, including adopting the NACS charging standard and establishing multiple partnerships. In this video, we'll check out 10 of these developments. If you're just starting your Aptera journey, check out my Aptera playlist for all the videos I've done on the vehicle so far. And if you're an Aptera veteran, this will just be a good reminder of how much they've accomplished in 1 year. Earlier this year, Aptera conducted a series of tests on their beta prototype vehicle, including acceleration, turning radius, braking, suspension, and steering. Aptera acquired Andromeda Interfaces, a human-machine interface company. Andromeda developed the Energy Tipster interface, which allows drivers to adjust their driving experience in real time to conserve energy. Seems like a perfect fit for Aptera. Aptera signed a supply agreement with Red Viking for automated guided vehicles, or AGVs, to be used in the final assembly of its vehicles. AGVs are autonomous robots used for moving and handling materials within a warehouse or other facility. They can operate without the need for a human operator or driver. Aptera announced a collaboration with Yazaki, a company that will assist in the production of parts and provide engineering services for the low and high voltage electrical harness. At the Electrify Expo in Long Beach, Aptera showcased their alpha prototype, which was able to capture the attention of everyone there. It was clear that the prototype, even though it was just a prototype, was enough to demonstrate the potential of the project and convince people of its feasibility. You can check out my first experience with Aptera at the Electrify Expo here. If you're thinking about getting an electric vehicle, check out my podcast. I interview actual EV owners to talk about their experiences with the EV they drive every day. From their specific car's features to their charging routines, each episode is a unique experience. Watch here on YouTube or on most major podcast platforms. Aptera will be using EV Energy Co's 21700 NMC 811 cylindrical cells. Boy, that's a smooth name right there. They'll be using those cells as the part of the structural battery packs for its vehicles. These battery packs will be produced in San Diego. I was lucky enough to be at Fully Charged Live in San Diego when Aptera unveiled their Gamma prototype. And let me tell you, it was the talk of the event. I have a few videos of the Gamma prototype in my Aptera playlist, or you can just check out this video for some nice footage. This vehicle was a hit and it definitely helped get people talking about Aptera. Aptera chose Maxeon Solar Technologies as the cell supplier for its solar production program. Aptera's solar engineers, through collaboration with Maxeon, have developed ultra-lightweight and curved solar panels that will set a new standard for efficiency. CPC Group, an Italian company specializing in composite materials, entered into an agreement with Aptera to manufacture its specialized composite bodies in Modena, Italy. This composite is carbon fiber sheet molding compound combined with glass sheet molding compound that can be recycled up to 5 times. Modena, which I'm probably pronouncing wrong, is also where this awesome electric motorcycle is produced. Stay tuned for a podcast episode with the owner of this beautiful motorcycle coming up in a few weeks. Aptera is the first EV company to integrate Tesla charging, now known as the North America Charging Standard. I did a quick video on the NACS plug that you can find right here. It'll be interesting to see how this plays out. Will Apteras be able to use superchargers? My guess is yes, but you never know. These are just a few of the things Aptera accomplished in 2022. If you want to learn more about each topic, I have links in the description below. What were some of the most significant developments in 2022, in your opinion? Let me know in the comments. Happy New Year to all of you. This has been a crazy year for me. Thank you for all of the new subscribers I got this year. Thank you for those of you that have been supporting me this year. You guys know who you are. I am beyond grateful for all the support. Here's to a great 2023. More videos from me, hopefully better quality, maybe even more often, maybe. And hopefully we'll see the production model of the Aptera in 2023. Thank you guys. I'll see you next year.